through their deeds and sacrifices, the 30 women and men we honor tonight have been role models for thousands and thousands of people. Through their examples, they give renewed hope that a socially just world is not only possible, but absolutely necessary for the survival of this planet, for the benefit of our children, and for the future of the entire world. The investments by Bread and Roses in the social justice projects that these women and men have been responsible for have yielded untold benefits throughout the greater Philadelphia community. They show that a small investment in social change can yield a powerful transformation within a community and by example through best practices, provide a vision of hope and a model of social change that can be replicated in cities and states throughout the entire nation. The Bread and Roses Community Fund has always operated with the belief that the most enduring change occurs not from the top down, but from the bottom up. The people with the greatest vision, the people who have the most insight into the nature of the contradictions of our society, all too frequently are those who have been silenced and marginalized by those with power and privilege in the United States. And the task of Bread and Roses, and our task by supporting this community fund, is to listen to those voices who provide a new leadership, a new vision of where this country needs to go. We live in an increasingly perilous time in America, where the institutions of political democracy and the rule of law are being endangered at every front. Constitutional rights that we read about in high school and in college, such as the right of habeas corpus, and legal victories that endured for half a century, like Brown v. Board in 1954, that outlawed legal racial Jim Crow segregation in our public schools, they are either being destroyed or being pushed back right in front of our very faces. Our public schools are more racially segregated today than when George Wallace stood in front of the schoolhouse door in Alabama and said, segregation forever. The number of Americans who are defined below the poverty level, plus the number of Americans who are defined as near poor, that is, a household who earn between $20,000 to $40,000 a year, amounts to over 100 million Americans. 100 million Americans, one-third of our total national population. Where is the demand for a war on poverty coming from Washington, D.C.?